Hi, kids. Welcome to the Beatitudes. Blessed are the meek, for they will inherit the earth. So, thank you for joining us today. We are going to hike up the mountain and join Jesus as he talks to the people. He hears their hurts and pains, both physically and inside their hearts. So I am so excited to learn about what Jesus says about blessed are the meek, for they will inherit the earth. So are you ready to go hiking? Why don't you decide how you are going to hike up the mountain? If you're going to hike, walk, roll, run, jog, skip, hop, whatever you would like to do. So let's go. Okay, kids, we are going to hike up the mountain, and it's fun to sing as we hike up. So let's sing. We are going to sing the song. We'll sing a few songs, one that has words that you'll hear after this one. But we're going to sing this song now. So let's sing as we hike. I've got the joy. I've got the joy, 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 joy. Down in my heart. Where? Down in my heart. Where? Down in my heart. I've got the joy, 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 joy. Down in my heart. Down in my heart to stay. And I'm so happy, so very happy. I've got the love of Jesus in my heart. And I'm so happy, so very happy. I've got the love of Jesus in my heart. Okay, kids, you keep hiking or marching or rolling or running or jumping up the mountain as we sing another song.
As we wait upon the Lord, we will wait upon the Lord, we will wait upon the Lord. Strength will rise as we wait upon the Lord, we will wait upon the Lord, we will wait upon the Lord. Our God, you reign forever. We will wait upon the Lord, we will wait upon the Lord.
We will wait.
Strength will rise as we wait upon the Lord, we will wait upon the Lord, we will wait upon the Lord.
Our God, you reign forever.
Do not fake it.
let's finish. Let's finish going up the mountain. Let's finish. Let's finish. Let's finish going up the mountain. Let's finish. Let's finish. Getting up the mountain to meet Jesus up there. Da, 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 da. Hike. Hike.
Mama, hi, kids. Woo! We made it up the mountain. How was your trip up the mountain? Did you make it? How did you get up there? Are you thirsty? Are you hungry? Huh. So kids, I know that we're not on a real mountain. I don't live anywhere near a big mountain, but some of you might, or maybe have a hill outside, but I'm in my kid's treehouse, which is kind of up tall. I had to go up some stairs. Whoa, got a little windy there. So I know we're pretending, and I would like you to pretend again by taking your binoculars. So pretend binoculars and look around, and what do you see? In my yard, I see a lot of logs because we chopped down a lot of trees to clear some space for our kids to play. I see some logs and leaves and grass and dirt and a swing set, and some of my kids' shoes are on the ground. So what do you see at your place? So kids, we're continuing talking about the Beatitudes, different ways that Jesus tells us how we can be happy. And today, here's the coloring sheet that I would love to email to you if your parents want to send me an email, called Blessed Are the Meek, for They Will Inherit the Earth. So we're going to talk about that today. But before we begin, I would like to read you a story that kind of goes along with what we're talking about. So if you can please open up your eyes and put on your listening ears. I'm going to set Mr. Owl down as we read, and then we'll continue on talking about Blessed Are the Meek. So this is called The Singer. Here we go. And maybe you've heard this story before, but it's a good one. So wherever Jesus went, lots of people went to. They loved being near him. Old people, young people, all kinds of people came to see Jesus. Sick people, well people, happy people, sad people, and worried people. Lots of them worrying about lots of things. What if we don't have enough food or clothes? Or suppose we run out of money? What if there isn't enough and everything goes wrong and we won't be all right? What then? When Jesus saw all the people, his heart was filled with love for them. They were like a little flock of sheep that didn't have a shepherd to take care of them. So Jesus sat them all down and talked to them. Maybe on a mountain, kind of like what we do. Remember, Jesus took his people up a mountain because back then they believed mountains were holy places where they could connect with God. The people sat quietly on a grassy mountainside and listened. From where they sat, they could see the blue lake glittering below them and little fishing boats coming in from a night's catch. The spring air was fresh and clear. See those birds over there? Jesus said. Everyone looked. Little sparrows were pecking at seeds along the stony pathway. Where do they get their food? Perhaps they have pantries all stocked up? Cabinets full of food? Everyone laughed. Who's ever seen a bird with a bag of groceries? No, Jesus said. They don't need to worry about that because God knows what they need and he feeds them. Here's the first. Well, I should keep that a little bit. Here's the page. And then the second page of the bird grocery shopping. And what about those wildflowers? Everyone looked. All around them were growing daisies, pure white lilies. Where do they get their lovely clothes? Do they make them, or do they go to work every day so they can buy them? Do they have closets full of clothes? Everyone laughed again. Who's ever seen a flower putting on a dress? No, Jesus said. They don't need to worry about that because God clothes them in royal robes of splendor. Not even a king is that well-dressed. See the clothes, or the flowers putting on clothes? That's funny. They have never met a king, but as they gazed over the lake, glittering and sparkling below them, the hillside dressed in reds, purples, and golds, they felt a great burden lift from their hearts. They could not imagine anything more beautiful. Little flock, Jesus said, you are more important than the birds, more important than flowers. The birds and the flowers don't sit and worry about things. And God doesn't want his children to worry either. God loves to look after the birds and the flowers, and he loves to look after you too. Jesus knew that God would always love and watch over the world he had made, everything in it, birds, flowers, trees, animals, everything, and most of all, his children. Even though people have forgotten the birds and the birds and the flowers hadn't forgotten, they still knew their song. It was the song all of God's creation had sung to him from the very beginning. It was the song people's hearts were made to sing. God made us. He loves us. He is very pleased with us. It was why Jesus had come into the world, to sing them that wonderful song. To sing it not only with his voice, but with his whole life, so that God's children could remember it and join in and sing it too. What a wonderful story, kids, to know that God loves us and he takes care of us. All right, kids, in our Bible story, we learned that God takes care of us and he loves us. And if God can take care of the birds and find them food and dress the flowers with beautiful colors, how much more do you think he takes care of his children? So today in the Beatitudes, we are talking about blessed are the meek, for they will inherit the earth. And that comes from Matthew 5:5. So if you want to turn in your Bibles, awesome. Otherwise, it's Matthew 5:5. Blessed are the meek, for they will inherit the earth. So when the people listening to Jesus heard this, they immediately recognized it. Their worship songs, which are found in the book of Psalms, which is before Matthew, sing of this, or spoke of this. Psalm 37:11 says, the humble will have land for their own. So they knew this. They knew about when Jesus was talking about land, they recognized it. So back then, land was very meaningful and important. To own land was to have a place in your community, to have honor, and to have a way to provide for your family. But most of the people Jesus talked to did not own land anymore. Landowners in their time were hated because they used violence to take that land. This is where Jesus again turns things upside down. With this promise, Jesus says the meek, which is another word for gentle or humble and kind people, are the ones who will receive the land. Not the people who use force and violence, and not just the physical land of Israel where they lived, but the whole earth. This also holds a powerful message for us about caring for the earth. So kids, I want to ask you a question. How do you care for the earth? So maybe stop and think for a second. What is the earth? It's anything really that you can see, your house, your land, your yard, your school, your friend's house, your grandparents' house. So think of the earth.
Mama, can I put my hood on?
She wants to wear her hood. There you go. You're nice and warm.
She's a little bit.
I will after you done my this video, okay? So this holds a powerful message to us about caring for the earth. So meek or humble people live with an awareness of others' needs. The planet, so they care about the planet, the animals, and other people. Meek and humble people remember that all the earth and all the land belong to God. It's not ours, but it's God's. They recognize how everything they have and receive, including land, belong to God, and they take care of it that way. This means using what they have with respect and love. All right, kids. My daughter here is holding Mr. Ollie right now. But there's a phrase that I would love you to remember as we think about that everything around that you can see is God's, and He created it, and He created us. So there's a good phrase that it's good for me to remember as well. And it is, I am God's child, and everyone else is God's child too. Can you repeat that after me? I am God's child, and everyone else is God's child too. This reminds us of two important things, or truths. One is that you are special, beloved, unique child of God who deserves love and respect. And each person, and then the second truth is that each person around you is also a child of God who is beloved, unique, special, and deserving of love and respect. That is what a meek or humble attitude looks like. It means you don't see yourself or your needs as more important than the needs of those around you. When we are meek, we are truly free. So we realize that everything and everyone is a gift worthy of love and care. How wonderful. So when we're meek and we're humble, it really is caring for others above yourself. And you know, we're not perfect. We're not always going to get that right. I know in my family, I sometimes think about my needs before above others. And you know, I will say sometimes that's okay, but you know, it's amazing how when you start focusing on other people, how sometimes our worries and fears and all that kind of go away. So, kids. Thank you for joining us. All right, kids, before we transition to our activity time, I would love to bless you. So please, okay, Ava and Andrew and Mr. Owl and Annabelle, can I have your hands out? Hands out. Very good. And kids, I want you to do the same. And once I say the blessing, okay, Mr. Owley, can you please move so I can be seen? Thank you. Once you have the blessing, I want you to take it, receive it, and put it in your heart. You know, Mr. Owley, you can have Mr. Owley for the prayer.
Or the activity.
Okay, kids, hands out.
Hands out.
God blesses you because you are gentle and kind to others. So take the blessing and put it in your heart. Can you put it in your heart, Ava? Put your blessing in your heart. Great job, kids. Did you put it in your heart? So kids, we have been talking about being humble, kind, meek, taking care of the earth and other people, and we're knowing that God loves us and that we are special, and we're also called to love others and think of them just like God thinks of us, that He cares for us, we are His child. So today, what I would like you to do for our activity is to, after I say what we're going to do, I want you to pause the video. So I would like you to find something that you treasure or that you think is really special and you love to take really good care of this item. So why don't you pause the video and go find that item and come back. So did you find your item? So I would like you once we get done with this, to pause and then you can talk with your friends and your family about why you chose your item. But what you're going to do is, you're going to have to pause again. But this time when you pause, I want you to find a little box, maybe something you're not using, or at least something big enough to fit your special item in there. So for example, my item that I chose is a picture of my family. And this was taken almost a year ago, but it was when I was pregnant with our youngest daughter, who maybe you saw pop in the video today. But it's my family, so it's my husband, my two, then the third is I am pregnant with her. But it's my family, and I treasure them. I love to take care of them. I hope I'm gentle with them. I try my best to make sure
I'm speaking life into them, and I, you know, my husband and I, we teach them about the Lord and how much they're loved. So I treasure them. And then for my box that I have is I have this basket here. So what I'm going to do is I want you to pause the video. You have your item, go find a box, or maybe if you have like a treasure chest or treasure toy box, or a container that your parents are using that you can put your items in, because we're going to write down why you treasure that item and why you take care of it and how you take care of them, so you know. So I'm gonna put my picture in here. So this is my box that I treasure. So it'll probably change things maybe as you grow up. Maybe you picked a stuffed animal, and maybe for a few years you've treasured this animal, but as you've grown up, maybe you have a new animal or something different that you treasure. So why don't you pause the video again, go find a special box or basket or whatever you have to store your items in. So do you have your item and your box? So like I said, at the end of the video, I would love you to talk about what items you chose with your family, so they know as well, like, why do you treasure that special toy? So then if you have a piece of paper and a pen or a writing utensil, you can write down, you can look at the screen and write, why do I treasure that item? And so then you can write down some words. Maybe it's because it's your family and you love them, or maybe it's a stuffed animal and they bring you comfort when you're scared, maybe with like a storm. So we had different ways. So I'll just write some words down, and maybe you, if any of those sound like something that you can resonate with, or sounds like why you treasure your items. So maybe they bring comfort. Maybe it's all of them. Or maybe, it's your family and you love your family. So love your family. So there's just different ways, and you can think of your own if you would like. And then I want you to write down, how do I take care of them, or how am I gentle with your treasure? So you can write down, how am I gentle with my treasure? So for me, with my family, I'm gentle with them by listening well, especially to my kids when they want something, or maybe they're upset and I can't really understand. Instead of me reacting right away, I can listen to them well, or I can, I pray for patience a lot of times. In situation, so even when if I'm in a situation that it's hard to have patience, I pray in my head. I'm like, okay, Lord, please give me patience. So pray for patience. How are you gentle with your treasure? So those are just some ways. Maybe you. So if Mr. Owly here was my treasure, or he is my treasure, you know, he's one of my treasures. But if it was like your stuffed animal, you can maybe hug them. So how you're gentle, maybe you wash them like once a week. Maybe you sing them songs or something. So how are you gentle? So kids, I want you to know that, and to think about that God loves us, and He gave us this beautiful world that we can be in, and wonderful people. And how can you, so last week we learned about bringing comfort to other people by writing them a note if they're sad. So now we can, I hope you can use these same ideas, and you can treasure people as well. And you can be kind to them and be gentle with them, because God loves us. And that's something that He would like us to do. We're going to be going through all the Beatitudes, so I thought it'd be good if we go through it all. So this comes from Matthew 5, verses 1 through 12. So it's a big chunk. So are you ready? Here we go. Now, when Jesus saw the crowds, he went up on a mountainside and sat down. His disciples came to him, and he began to teach them. And these are the Beatitudes. He said, "Blessed are the poor in spirit, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are those who mourn, for they will be comforted. Blessed are the meek, for they will inherit the earth. Blessed are those who hunger and thirst for righteousness, for they will be filled. Blessed are the merciful, for they will be shown mercy. Blessed are the pure in heart, for they will see God. Blessed are the peacemakers, for they will be called children of God. Blessed are those who are persecuted because of righteousness, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are you when people insult you, persecute you, and falsely say all kinds of evil against you because of me. Rejoice and be glad, because great is your reward in heaven, for in the same way they persecuted the prophets who were before you." Thank you so much for joining us today, kids, as we talked about blessed are the meek, for they will inherit the earth. I'm so glad that you were here and that we were able to learn a little bit about what it means to be meek and about how much God loves us and gave us this world, and that we can be kind and gentle to it and the people in it as well. So, and about your treasures. So I hope you take some time to talk about them with your family and friends and why you treasure them and how you are gentle with your treasure. So I'm going to close this in a word of prayer now. So please fold your hands and close your eyes, and I'm going to say a prayer. Generous Creator, we praise you for making this beautiful world. It all belongs to you. Help us use what we have and treat the earth with respect and love. We want to be gentle, kind, and humble, true strength in your eyes. Help us remember we are your children and everyone else is too. Amen. Amen. I hope you have a great day, and I look forward to seeing you next time as we talk about another Beatitude. Thanks for joining.